such great value that now Dad's just as keen on getting one as me. Hey, Dad? Ow!
Do me a favor, plug me into a Sega.
Hey everyone, today I want to talk about the Sega Master System and my Sega Master System collection. As far as my collection goes, something interesting is that years ago, maybe 3 or 4 years ago, I had a pretty good sized Sega Master System collection. But as time went on and certain things happened and things happened in the channel, I ended up selling off my entire Sega Master System collection. And I wasn't even that sad about it at the time. And recently, upon Pixel Game Squad starting and the NES Pursuit being booted back up, I started getting into collecting for the system again. But this time around, and I don't know exactly for what reason, the system started to hit like super home with me as far as nostalgia goes. Everything about the system and everything about playing the games this time around means a little bit more. It's almost weird because, say, like the NES, growing up with the NES, I grew up with the Sega Master System as well. But I always had a deep nostalgic attachment to the NES. And I didn't really for the Sega Master System until this time around. Something in my brain has triggered my senses of me playing as a kid, and those feelings are now the same way I feel towards the NES. I'm drawn to it. I love it. The sounds, the music is something that gets me excited in a way it never did. Now, I don't really have an explanation for why. That's just where we're at. Now, let's see what I have in my Sega Master System collection. Don't get too excited. It's not huge.
Sega Master System.
Sega!
We have California Games, a game that has been ported over to many different systems and many different consoles, and it's more of a nostalgic thing for me, more of something I grew up loving. I know a lot of people talk trash on it. There's a whole JonTron video on this series, but I love this game. Thunderblade, a game that I always considered to be like the rival to Tiger Heli, whether that's true or not, and it also recommends you use the control stick for this game, right on the back of the box. So if you got a control stick and you got Thunderblade, you got a combo. Choplifter, another helicopter game, but this time around, it is not a top-down like Thunderblade. It is a side-scrolling helicopter shooter, and it is a pretty good game, a game that I enjoy, I'll say that. Rocky on the Sega Master System was a game I played so much when I was younger with my brother Adam and my brother Nathan. What stands out about this game is, for a boxing game at the time on an 8-bit console, the game looks beautiful. The animations are fantastic. Playing this game, as opposed to a lot of games like Ring King or even Mike Tyson's Punch-Out, the graphics on this stood out to me big time, and they still do to this day. Oh look, another one. Altered Beast. I got this from Tyler, formerly known as iRetroGamer. Now his show is here. This was a fantastic gift. Altered Beast to me is a game that I love, a series that I love. I have so much background into this game on all different types of consoles. So regardless of what a lot of people I've seen say lately, I love this. It's fantastic and it holds a lot of heart for me. Great Football. Now I would say it's not great football, it's mediocre football. But back in the day, really, Tecmo Bowl is the only 8-bit football game that I ever really enjoyed. So nothing against it, it's just the time that it came out. Zaxxon 3D is a fun experience, especially, well, I definitely say you gotta use the 3D glasses, otherwise your eyes are gonna be hurting, just like some of the other NES games that did 3D as well. But it's definitely worth trying out. It's also a fun game, minus the 3D. It is a, it's a fun shooter. Double Dragon on the Sega Master System, what a fun game. I will say I like the NES version better, but the thing that this game holds above the NES is the fact that it's two-player co-op. I wish the NES version was, because I like the way it plays a little bit better. But otherwise, it is still a fun game to pick up and play with your friend. Co-op, you have the option, so it's there. Mercs, this was a gift from Donnie, and oh boy, this is sealed. Now, this game I thought was from Brazil, and I still kind of think so, but there was people in the comments saying it's from Italy. But regardless of where it's from, Mercs, this copy of it is the most perfect game, not just I've seen or owned on the Sega Master System, but in general. I have never owned a copy of a game more pristine, more perfect than this, with even all the stickers still on it in immaculate mint condition. So Donnie, thank you. Cyborg Hunter. I picked this up in Florida at Rad Junk with Joe and Sam, the purple-haired wonder that everybody seems to love. And this is a different game. It's I wouldn't say it's a fun game, but if you can get it for, you know, 10, 15 bucks, do it if you don't have it. Plus, the box looks different, so that's always fun for the Sega Master System. Wanted, a game that uses the Sega Light Phaser. I am a sucker for anything Western. I grew up watching my dad watch nothing but Westerns. He still does to this day. So I have a huge soft spot in my heart for anything Western or cowboy. So this is fun. Kensiden or Kensiden. I talked about this a little bit more in a pickups video that I did with Mort, so I won't go into it too much, but it's fun. You play as a ninja, it's side-scrolling, it's pretty decent, and your sprite is pretty darn big, and I'm a fan of that. Action Fighter. I've never played this, so I won't pretend like I know anything about the game. If you guys have played Action Fighter, let me know. It looks like a top-down shooting game with a car, some vehicle combat. So let me know if you've played it, if it's actually fun. Astro Warrior. Definitely the most common of all the top-down shooters on the Sega Master System, but this one to me is the most fun. It is the one that I played when I was younger the most, and it has stuck with me since, and even recently visiting it after years of not touching it, it was just as fun as I remembered. Actually, I will say it was even better than I remembered. So Astro Warrior is definitely common, it's definitely cheap, so which makes it definitely, definitely worth getting. Alien Syndrome. I played this a few years back with Ricky when I had my other collection growing, and we had a fun time playing it. Now, I don't know if that's just because Ricky and I were playing it and watching each other play it and taking turns playing it. I don't know if that's what made it exciting to us. Anytime you're with a friend playing a game, whether it's co-op or single player, you're always having a fun time when someone else is in the room. So Alien Syndrome, my opinion might be biased, but I'll say it's fun. Reggie Jackson's Baseball. I'm not a sports guy at all by any means. I'm sure you've guessed that by now if you watch the show. But I kind of base all my opinions off playing Base Wars on the NES, so I struggle with enjoying many baseball games at all because I have really no heart for baseball, if I'm just being honest. It's not me, but I have no hate, so let me know if this is good. Does it hold a candle to the excitement that Base Wars brings, does it? The graphics looks pretty decent though on the back. Shooting Gallery. Now I'll say anytime you can play a video game where you get to use some sort of accessory or add-on, it makes the game a little more exciting. I wouldn't say it makes the game good. I know there's a lot of stuff that gets added onto video games that makes the games terrible when you have to play with certain peripherals, but I'll say this is enjoyable. It's a good time. You'll smile while playing it. I bet you will. If you enjoy Excitebike and you've ever thought to yourself, I would love this if it was a top-down isometric view done in a little bit different graphic styling, well then you got yourself Enduro Racer, a game that keeps you going with some cool sound effects. That's all I really, really hold on to with this game is the sound effects. Monopoly on the Sega Master System. Yeah, it's just Monopoly. But what's interesting about this video game is that the more common version of the cartridge is spelled incorrectly, mono space poly. But the uncommon cartridge, which I didn't know years ago that I passed up on, was one that's spelled Monopoly. So it's kind of interesting that the misspelling, the one with the space, is the more common one. So if you find the one that just says Monopoly straight up, that's the more uncommon one. Pick it up. Great Golf. Now the interesting thing is I love golf video games actually, but this is after like the 16-bit generation. So 8-bit golf games I've never been able to get into. But if you like Great Golf, let me know down in the comments below. Great Baseball. I have nothing to say about this. It's baseball that's pretty great, I guess. Afterburner. Now there's a lot of video games in the 8-bit days that played off this type of view and the way you play Afterburner, and I don't normally like them. I will say my top choice of these style of games is the Afterburner game on the Sega Master System. One of the greatest, in my opinion, Space Harrier on Sega Master System. The music at the beginning is beautiful. It's epic and it's heartwarming and it's interesting with the visuals that are on the screen. It makes you wonder what's going on. I love the voice samplings of the guy before he goes, when he goes, "Get ready!" It's fantastic, it's nostalgic, and it still is a good game. And the graphics were unique to me at the time. It almost felt like some sort of Mode 7, even though it wasn't. Alex Kidd, The Lost Stars, and if you like any Alex Kidd games or even side-scrolling platforming type games, you're gonna love this. It's not one of the best out there by any means, but it's fantastic and you're gonna enjoy your journey in this game. Transbot. This is a game that I've played numerous times, but I never remember what the game is actually like when I go to talk about it. I don't know if that means I didn't really enjoy the game as much as I thought. Here's what I have to say about the game. I think visually looking at it and watching someone playing it is more fun than it actually is. That's kind of what I would say about this, but still worth it and a great game to have in your collection. It also is my first game that I'm showing that's a Hue card, not an actual cartridge. So if you didn't know that and you're new to the Sega Master System, yes, there's a lot of games that are played on a Hue card. Lord of the Sword. This game reminds me a lot of Astyanax for the Nintendo Entertainment System. You're a big, buff, burly guy. You're killing everything that gets in your path, and it kind of speaks true to what I think of personally when I think of the 8-bit days of gaming. I think of side-scrolling. I think of just whacking everything that comes in your direction. I don't think of thinking too hard in a video game. Just playing and having some simple fun. This is kind of what Lord of the Sword is. Aztec Adventure. This game reminds me a little bit of The Legend of Zelda as far as gameplay goes. Now, don't take that too far to heart and go, wow, I'm gonna go buy it, it better be as good as Zelda. No, it's not. But it's kind of a similar type of game that takes you on an Aztec Adventure. Look at that, the box actually speaks true to what the game is. My favorite looking box on the Sega Master System as of right now, Rampage. This is ported over to a ton of different consoles from the 8-bit days to even the new gen days to even having a movie starring Dwayne The Rock Johnson. Who would have thought that when this game first came out that we'd be getting Dwayne The Rock Johnson in a movie about this video game? But it's fun, it's different. You climb up buildings, you bash the buildings down, you go on a rampage, you eat people, you eat dynamite, you fart it out, all different stuff like that. So it's fun. I don't know if it's because I grew up playing it like crazy, but it's a fun game. Well, I guess everyone else agrees because they made a ton of them. A very confusing title, Rambo First Blood Part 2. It's kind of like Ikari Warriors if you play with Sylvester Stallone, so if you think about it, really, is there a better way to play a game? You get to play Ikari Warriors, but basically, as this guy, same guy who's in the Rocky game, yeah. He got two games? I didn't even think about that till now. Does he have another one on the Sega Master System? Wow. Miracle Warriors, Seal of the Dark Lord. This game has one of the most beautiful box arts for the Sega Master System. I know this console gets a lot of hate for its box art, but this reminds me a lot of the Atari days when we got the cool, epic, hand-drawn covers, and this is no different. This is also like an RPG game, and it's interesting on the back. It says, players, it's one player, but five if games are saved and alternated. I've never played it that way at all, so I don't know if I would recommend doing that. But regardless, Miracle Warriors is worth checking out if you like RPG type games. Ghost House, a game that's also a Hue card, by the way. In this game, you play as Dracula, and it kind of reminds me of Mappyland. If it was darker, take the dark level in Mappyland and make that most of the game, and then switch out Mappy. And that's basically what this game is to me. If it's not that, and that's not what you feel like it represents, you know, sometimes I do my best job explaining what a video game is by comparing it to others. So that's kind of what I think of when I think of this game. Ghostbusters. I've never played this version of the game, and I've never seen anyone play it either. I do know Ghostbusters has a bad reputation back in the day for their games, except like one or two, and I can't remember if this is one of the ones that are good or not. So let me know, is this a garbage game, or is it a good one? Hang On and Astro Warrior. This is a combo box. This comes with two different games, Hang On and Astro Warrior. It is the combo cartridge. Comes with both games. Hang On is a fantastic, one of the better motorcycle racing games for me back in the day, and also comes with Astro Warrior, which I said earlier, I love that game. So this is definitely worth it, and it's very cheap. I didn't know I had two copies of Afterburner. These are the last three games in my SMS collection, and they are all loose. And the first one is Wonder Boy in Monster Land. This game is a little bit pricey, so if you can find it for a good deal, I would definitely recommend getting it. Wonder Boy is a fantastic series. It is one of my favorite series out there in video games, especially in the side-scrolling slash platforming world. Definitely recommend getting it. Even if you have to pay a little bit higher price for it, it is worth it. You will have a great time playing this video game. R-Type. I played a ton of different variations of R-Type in my life, going from the arcades into the Super Nintendo and other ones as well, but this is one that I never actually played, so I need to play this one. Let me know if you guys have played it. I do love the R-Type series, so how does it hold up on the Sega Master System? There's a lot of video games out there that are really important to me on the Sega Master System, but the most important to me is this last game, and that's Phantasy Star. This game is one of those games where when you hear it, it just takes you to a place. I know we all have those games where when you hear about it or when you play it or you see a cutscene or you hear the music or you look at a picture of it, it just gets you almost like emotional. Super Mario Bros. 2 does that to me. It's one of those games that just gets me no matter where I am, what I'm doing, I see it and it gets me. I'm sucked in, emotional, and in all different ways. And this game does the same thing. The music to me, and captures my childhood. It's one of those video games where I heard the music playing all the time throughout my house when I was younger. I would be doing my homework. I would be taking care of the dog. I would be playing outside. And when my brother was inside the house, my brothers, but mostly Adam, I would hear this game playing. It does it for me. And when I play it too, it just gets me in that mood of like, man, I miss being a kid. So Phantasy Star, this version in particular, Sega Master System, the series, whatever, if you like the series, awesome. This is the one that gets me the most. That was my Sega Master System collection. And remember, everything you saw here today, every single game has been picked up since the NES Pursuit has come back. Let me know if you guys have a Sega Master System collection. Let me know if you guys have been struck with an old console, not knowing that you had this crazy nostalgia for. Now, all of a sudden, this nostalgia is getting you in the head, and now you're finding yourself trying to get every game you can for a specific console. Let me know down in the comments below. I so much appreciate you guys being here. Thank you so much. Subscribe, like the video if you want, and we'll see you guys soon. Have a good day.